liberal arts education is a tricky concept. It's sort of work in progress. People still debate what that means and what it entails. It's evolving. It's constantly evolving. It's distinguished from a practical education, a pre-professional kind of education. So instead of preparing someone for, you know, life as an artist or life as a doctor, you are preparing them for the possibility of anything. And that's really what liberal arts education is about. You're specializing in the pursuit of knowledge that is not immediately, obviously practical, and yet it will, of course, enrich everything you do. So that's what a liberal arts education means to me.
I've taught for 9 years at Harvard, and before that I taught at the Eastman School of Music and the University of Rochester, and before that I taught at the University of Virginia, and those are the three jobs I've had in my life.
I taught at Rutgers University in New Jersey prior to coming to Harvard, where I have taught for 7 years now.
Well, at Harvard, I teach two general education courses. One of them is called Putting Modernism Together, which is about music and painting and literature from 1872 to 1927. And my other course is the history of the English language. I also teach courses in the music department on opera and on the meaning of music, how we interpret music. That's why I taught in music school for some years before I came here. Most of my work is on the intersection between, among various artistic media, the ways in which painting, music, literature interact with one another.
I teach courses in Victorian literature, that's my specialty, 19th century British literature, but also courses in gender and sexuality studies. But here at Harvard, I've been focusing most of my attention on large lecture courses on 19th century British literature and culture. And I'm happy to report that there seems to be a taste for 19th century British literature and culture at Harvard, because my two large lecture courses are now the largest humanities courses at Harvard. Roughly 1,000 students take my two lecture courses every year. So I am exposed to a lot of students from all walks of life, all different kinds of people, and it's been a joy.
I'm teaching the history of the English language course, and I hope to be playing, when we talk about lyric poems, I'll be talking about musical settings of some of the texts we studied. The other course I'm teaching for Fujian is called Reading Fiction, mostly short fiction.
Well, I'm going to be teaching two courses in Beijing. The first course is an abbreviated version of my big lecture course here called Crime and Horror in Victorian Literature and Culture. And that course is a survey of horrible things in 19th century. There's a really unsettling and yet intellectually stimulating contrast between beautiful language and disturbing content. And the other course I'm going to teach is a course on Charles Dickens, who was probably the greatest writer of the 19th century, one of the greatest writers in English ever. And both of these courses will teach students numerous different things. The first thing that the courses will do is they will improve students' reading abilities and give students an opportunity to sharpen their writing skills as well. That's something we'll be discussing quite a bit. The courses will also introduce students to typical American university literature courses, especially literature courses taught by, you know, the upcoming generation of teachers. I mean, these are youthful, cutting-edge approaches to literature.
是一种前所未有的全新的体验。我们邀请来自哈佛、耶鲁、哥伦比亚、 美国顶尖大学的教授来到中国，只为呈现美国最精英的博雅教育。遍布全球的辅仁校友网络将是一个转折的开始。